All right, guys, as you can see, we've moved to the bathroom here. As you can also see, it's a little bit of a tight setup in here, but we really wanted to demonstrate how the majority, probably the most common setup in the bathroom is gonna look. As you can see here, we have vanity toilet tub. And as most of you also probably know, the bathroom is the most dangerous room in the home. 60% of all slip and falls happen in the bathroom. I should know, I have a 4-year-old. We can't get her out of the bath without her toppling all over the place. So, Alicia, from your experience though, why is the bathroom the most dangerous room that you've dealt with?
Well, one thing you talked about, Jed, was the small space. You know, you are a little more confined in here. So one minor slip can cause you to hit your head on any surface around here. So we're slippery, it is smaller, and people don't want people in here with them. So they're usually on their own in this room.
You know, talk about that just a little bit, about the privacy aspect of home medical equipment. Why is that so important to not just people in the professional space, but just the general public out there that would be candidates for products like this?
Well, Jed, do you want someone in the bathroom with you?
Depends on what I'm doing, but the majority of the time,
no. Right. So it's just like we said earlier, you know, people want their independence in every aspect of life, and for sure, the bathroom. And it's one thing to have, you know, a healthcare professional come in. I feel like if anything, they're a little more okay with us here in the bathroom than they are a loved one.
Oh, for sure.
But most of the time when they're at home, they want loved ones there taking care of them and helping out. So if you can give them, you know, their independence in the bathroom, that's huge. So they're not sharing that with their family.
Yeah, that's a great point. So ways we can give them independence in the bathroom. The current items that are out there, they're going to be the probably the most common things people think about for bathroom safety equipment, is a wall mount grab bar, an elevated toilet seat, just a typical blow mold toilet seat, and then a shower chair.
Right.
So in your experience, and probably for those of us that are non-professional caregivers as well, what kind of challenges can those three items present?
Right. Well, those have been the most common for so long that I think a lot of people don't even know there's other options out there.
Very true.
But those do run a lot of risks. In the bathroom, you think you're in a small space, but when you've got someone sitting on a chair and they're trying to reach across to the bar that's on the wall, surprisingly, all of a sudden, this small contained space becomes big.
Very true.
So when you're leaning off, you know, you're already getting someone that's gonna like maybe fall, and then you're on tile, it's slippery, things like that. So, and then the chair itself, depending on how, you know, the height difference, like even once they needed a certain height to sit on, and then once they're sitting, sometimes their feet aren't touching. So you run into that. The bath chair is great. You know, we have seen a lot of those, but they're great when you're in the shower, when you're setting. And then when you get wet and you're trying to get out, and that again, across, you think the bar is right there on the wall, it's not that far. When you're reaching for that and you're wet and you're slippery, we've seen a lot of falls with that.
So I'm leaning against something people often use as a pseudo grab bar.
Absolutely.
Have you seen a lot of these broken off the wall for that
usage? Absolutely. Yeah. Yes. I mean, a lot of bathrooms you walk into and all of a sudden there's just a hole in the wall and you don't even have to ask. You just know.
It's where the towel holder used to be.
Used to be, right. Yes. Yeah.
Well, for all the challenges you just discussed there, I'm going to run through some of the great features and benefits of our security pole with curved grab bar, but I'm going to ask you to excuse yourself so I can find a little space here. So we talked about small space, and that's really where I'd like to start with the security pole and curved grab bar by Stander. Installation can be a really intimidating part of any type of bathroom product. Now, coming from the world of medical equipment, I sold a countless number of wall mount and tub mount grab bars and elevated toilet seats. I would sell a $25 grab bar to some poor little old lady who's gonna have to go home and drill holes in her wall to install that. And I can tell you, that is an intimidating process, and not just for someone who's maybe a little advanced in age, but just maybe who's someone who's not mechanically inclined. So what we've done with the security pull and curve grab bar is make it completely tension mounted. So as you can see here, you'll see a thread pattern. We spin this nut in the middle and it extends like an expandable curtain rod, and it's held in via tension. The great thing about this piece is right out of the box, it will work with ceiling heights anywhere from 7 to 10 feet. It does not also have to span the actual ceiling trusses. as long as it will work with just about any type of drywall type of ceiling. Again, we get a lot of questions of how the foot works on this. The foot will work with the nicest Italian travertine tile or the thickest shag carpet as well. So it goes in extremely sturdy and has a 300-pound weight capacity. Another great talking point here is you can literally mount this anywhere in the bathroom. So some people are gonna need it maybe a little closer to the tub. Maybe someone wants it between toilet and vanity. Wherever they want it, it can absolutely go there. I want to demonstrate how this can most commonly be used to replace the top five just common commodity items that are sold in the bathroom safety market today. So first I want to talk about how this can replace both a elevated toilet seat and a toilet safety frame. So in a common setting here, of course, I would be on the toilet. Normally I would need some sort of elevation or some sort of toilet safety frame to help me here. But with the swiveling curved grab bar that swivels 360 degrees, locks every 45 degrees, I can use it to, with both hands, use this ladder grab bar to help me stand up off the toilet and stabilize. Now again, we talked about in the living room section where sitting down can be viewed as not something that is a big mobility challenge, and frankly, it absolutely is. Falling down or flopping down onto a toilet seat can be absolutely extremely dangerous. I personally have been called out because someone did that and actually broke the tank off the back of their toilet. So it really is something that we want to make sure we give them their best chance to have a positive experience when it comes to both sitting and standing. Now, we get to the prone position, okay? Now it's time to transition in and out of the tub. Again, this will swivel 360 degrees, so I'm going to move it to just a slightly different setting. Again, in a prone position. Alicia talked about how we can have a challenge reaching for a grab bar that's mounted in here. You can see how all my weight's getting going forward and I got most of it on one foot, and that's not what we want to happen. Again, if I did that, I would be leaving the solid part of the tile floor to move into the tub while my momentum's going forward, which can be extremely dangerous. With the security pull and curved grab bar, I can keep it two-handed or even go up just a little bit higher. You can see how I can stay in a prone position and very safely transition over the tub wall. Now, Alisa also mentioned the shower seat, which is a great product. It's great to give you a stable point to sit when you're in here using a shower wand. But again, how do you stand up from it and how do you safely transition over the tub wall? Well, the security pull and curved grab bar is that answer. So if you can imagine, I have a toilet safety seat here, a shower safety seat here, and I'm sitting, I can use the ladder grab bar to stand up off of that shower chair. Then once I get into a prone position, I can move this into a different part. And again, locks every 45 degrees. Now I have a stable anchor point to help me stable to transition away from the shower chair and over the tub wall. Now, so often we see, it's not just when the transition happens. Sometimes it's just getting kind of our bearings back before we move from that point. So that's a big talking point here. Even if you need to lean on this for a second, it has that ability because of the secure install and the 300-pound weight capacity. So for all those reasons, the security pull and curved grab bar really ticks so many boxes all by itself. And the fact that this comes all-inclusive in a single box, being able to, again, support ceiling heights anywhere from 7 to 10 feet and fit just about anywhere is such an enormous value add. So we've talked a lot about this piece being used in the bathroom. Want to review some of the challenges that this actually helps solve for us as well. We talked about the cleanliness issue and also the aesthetic issue of the elevated toilet seat. By cleanliness issue, I mean it really is a really hard piece to keep clean. Plus, if you got your family or your grandkids over, you don't want them having to climb up on that. We also talked about keeping the center of gravity really prone and being able to transition over the tub wall. We talked about, again, not having to reach for a wall mount or a tub mount grab bar. And then again, just the aesthetic issue of a toilet safety frame. This really is such a more aesthetically pleasing piece. Now on the aesthetic piece, we've talked about this and you've obviously showcased it in white. This also comes in black and it comes with or without the curved grab bar. We have a lot of people who like to use the black one in the bathroom depending on their decor. But again, the black one works really well for a living room, for a bedroom. The white works great for a laundry room or a kitchen. So there's so many other values that can be brought to this outside of the bathroom space. Again, want to remind you, we have links below to all this information, please view videos, please look at the reviews on this piece and see how it's benefited people's lives. And we have our standard team ready to answer your questions. And we hope, again, this generates conversations of how can we make these situations that are such a huge challenge and such a privacy issue, and frankly, a pride issue, how do we make them better by implementing a standard item into that equation?